Hello and welcome to Neha's Cook House with Aloo Paratha. Aloo Paratha is a famous Indian dish which is also popular all over South Asia. It's made by cooking Indian flatbread stuffed with spiced mashed potato mixture on a tawa. It's a super delicious and satisfying breakfast you cannot miss. So let's start with ingredients. 4 medium-sized boiled and peeled potatoes, 2 cup wheat flour, water to knead the dough, 8 to 10 tablespoon cooking oil, 1/4 cup chopped green coriander, 2 tablespoon finely chopped green chilies, 1 teaspoon dry fenugreek leaves, 1 teaspoon dry mango powder, 1 teaspoon red chili powder, 1 teaspoon roasted cumin seed, 1 teaspoon carom seeds, 1 teaspoon coriander seeds, salt according to taste, 1/2 teaspoon garam masala powder. So let's start making them. First of all, let's knead the dough. For this, take 2 cups of wheat flour in a bowl. After that, add 1 teaspoon salt, 1 tablespoon oil, and mix them well so that oil and salt blends well with wheat flour. Now take some water and add little by little to knead the dough to the right consistency. Dough consistency is very important to get soft and tasty parathas. We want the dough to be medium soft. Dough is kneaded now. In total, I have used around 1 cup of water. Now cover the bowl and let it sit for 15 minutes to set it well. In between, let's start making a stuffing for parathas to give it a dhaba style taste. For this, take 1 teaspoon coriander seeds, 1 teaspoon carom seeds, and 1 teaspoon roasted cumin seeds. Now crush them coarsely in a pestle, as freshly made masala gives nice taste and aroma to parathas. If you don't have these spices, you can still make parathas without them. This is how it looks like after crushing. We will add this later in potato stuffing. Now take some boiled potatoes in a bowl and mash them using a masher, or just use hands to mash them. If you see any big chunks, break them with hands, as big chunks can break parathas while rolling. Potatoes are mashed now. So add masala we made earlier, green chilies, green coriander, red chili powder, amchur powder, or you can also use chaat masala, garam masala, kasuri methi to give nice aroma to parathas, and salt. Now mix all ingredients well. If you don't have any of above spices, you can still make aloo parathas. I am adding these spices to make them extra delicious. After 15 minutes, let's check the dough. You can see the dough has become smooth. Now knead it a little to make it even smoother. Now place potato stuffing, dough, and some dry wheat flour to roll parathas at one place. I am going to show you 3 methods to roll parathas. For first method, make a big dough ball. I have taken almost 2 chapati sized dough and roll it in hands like this. Now cover it in dry flour, press it a little bit and roll into 4 to 5 inch disc by using a rolling pin. Just keep the edges thin. Now place around 2 big tablespoons of stuffing in center. Close it like this. And again cover it in flour. Now gently press it with hands to make it little thin and spread flour uniformly. Stretches as much as you can by pressing with hands so that paratha doesn't tear apart while rolling with pin. Now roll it gently with rolling pin to smoothen out the stuffing and to make paratha little thin. Be careful not to push too much pressure, otherwise paratha can tear. Now it is rolled well. Now let's see second method. For this, take two small dough balls of equal size and roll them into equal size chapatis. Now uniformly spread 2 big tablespoons of stuffing on one of the chapatis. And then cover it with second chapati. Seal the edges completely so that stuffing doesn't come out while cooking parathas. Now dust some dry flour on both sides of paratha and gently press it to smooth it out, or you can also use rolling pin to smoothen it perfectly. For third method, take dough ball of same size as first method and roll into 5 to 6 inch discs. Now take 2 big tablespoons of stuffing and place on one half of disc. Then fold the other half over it and gently seal the edges. Now cover it with dry flour and remove any extra dough from edges with knife. Now press it gently with hands and spread as much as you can. Now roll it with rolling pin like before. Now let's cook paratha. For this, heat tawa on medium high heat. When it's hot enough, gently put paratha on tawa and cook for 30 to 40 seconds. Now flip it and apply oil all over it. After 30-40 seconds, flip it again and apply oil on this side also. Now keep pressing gently with ladle and cook from both sides for around 2 minutes till you get nice light brown spots like this. Now our paratha is ready, so take it out in a plate and similarly cook all parathas. Now they are ready to taste. Aloo parathas taste just awesome. Very similar to parathas you find on Indian roadside dhabas. They are perfect breakfast and usually served with butter, chutney, curd or Indian pickles. Kids love them, so you can also pack it in their lunchbox. Try this easy recipe and enjoy. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like it and don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you want to try more recipes, please click on above videos. Have a healthy eating day.